Hey guys, G-Wizzer here, and yes, I'm back on the 3DS. And today, we're going to play yet another fucking free-to-play Pokemon game. However, the good news is that the developers behind the last free-to-play disaster, Genius Sonority, didn't make this one. Instead, it's by another company called Umbrella. You may know them as the creators of Hey You Pikachu for the Nintendo 64, Pokemon Channel for the GameCube, and My Pokemon Ranch for WiiWare. My Pokemon Ranch especially had these ugly models. Said models would be recycled for their latest Pokemon series, which is Pokemon Rumble. It first got its start on WiiWare in, I think it's 2009, where it was basically a button masher. And Pokemon Rumble was critically mediocre at best. It was, like I said, it was nothing but a button masher with models recycled from My Pokemon Ranch. Pokemon Rumble had its faults, too. The game only included Pokemon from Red and Blue and Diamond and Pearl, not from Gold and Silver or Ruby and Sapphire. The inclusion situation was rectified for the game's 3DS sequel, Pokemon Rumble Blast, or Super Pokemon Rumble in PAL and Japanese regions. The gameplay is basically the same in the 3DS sequel, let's just put it at that. Oh, and they have Street Pass features. But at least it included all the Pokemon. Then they made Pokemon Rumble U for the Wii U, which is pretty much the same and included all the Pokemon. Except they had NFC figures. Unfortunately, I don't recall this entire situation, but I hear that either the NFC figures were difficult to find in North America, or they were not released in North America at all. I'm not entirely sure on the situation, but I do know that it didn't go well. And here we are. April 8th, 2015, on the 3DS. Umbrella just released their latest game, and yeah. Like I stated earlier, it's a free-to-play title. We all know how that went. If you recall, a couple months ago, I did a video on a 3DS game called Pokemon Shuffle, made by Genius Sonority. It is a very, very, very flawed game that even to this day still sucks, believe it or not. The game not only forces microtransactions on you and disables time traveling, but also rips off from other good puzzle games like Candy Crush, Bejeweled, and to a lesser extent, Puyo Puyo. If that isn't a recipe for disaster, I don't know what is. But enough stalling, let's just check out this other free-to-play game. Yep, they made Pokemon Rumble World. They made a fourth one. Yep. You can just tell this is gonna suck. I mean, just look at the graphics. I mean, if the thing wasn't swirling around right now, I would talk. So as you can see, the graphics really suck. But this is from a series where the graphics are meant to suck. And yeah, let's just go. I want to get this over with. I want to get done with this free-to-play bullshit. Toy Pokemon live in the Kingdom of Toys. No shit, Sherlock. And yeah, the copyright screen, it's made by Umbrella. It's 8:43. What is it, measuring the time? This ain't a good sign. This means time traveling won't work in this one? I'm disappointed. It's saving. This is the Kingdom of Toys. Welcome, G-Wizard. This is my kingdom, and I'm the king. G-Wizard, I hear that you like Pokemon very much. I feel the same way, G-Wizard. I turned it down a little. Basically, the king is saying I'm a Pokemaniac, which is, in some ways, disrespectful, because I don't play Pokemon Shuffle. So, basically, he's telling me to capture toy Pokemon. I don't care. Tell me to collect 11 species. Alright, he's gonna lend me his Pikachu. Alright, you got a strong Pokemon already. That's good. Okay. Found a Treecko already. Alright, so we don't need to play Alpha Sapphire to get this. Alright. So we move, and yes. Unfortunately, the frame rate is worse than the WiiWare version. But at least it's in 3D, unlike Pokemon Shuffle, so Alright, so... So, pretty much circle pad to move and A to attack. Other than the dipped frame rate, it's going out okay so far. We're in a battle, ready? It didn't give us a title screen yet. What's with this? Might as well beat him down. There. We're getting some money. Alright, can we spend it on the crappy microtransactions this game has? Hope so. Gotta keep turning up, it's kinda quiet. Automatically attack if you approach an enemy. Oh great, the game has auto-aim, like Call of Duty! Alright. And we're forced to switch, unfortunately. I don't care, I wanna switch. Oh wait, I think I have to switch, because Torchic is stronger, technically. Whatever, I'm just gonna keep going with Pikachu for now. And I can move using the D-pad. Alright. So we need to use Torchic for this. I gotta help myself. Wait, does the trick work in this one? Yep. Mashing A to refill faster, or wind faster, works in this one too. Die, Trico! Alright, so we're gonna move forward. You don't even need to press A, just auto-attack, Call of Duty style. Yeah, they stole this from Call of Duty. Oh, and we got Trico. Look at that, one power than Torchic. Actually, that's a starter picked in Alpha Sapphire. Yeah. Oh, a boss. Swampert, ooh. Alright, I know where I'm going with this. Flying faster. Bam. I don't think auto attack works on the boss, though. And he's giving me a potion. Or I'm giving myself a potion. I'm getting confused here. There we go. Beat Swampert. I find it hilarious how a little Trico beat a huge Swampert. But hey, that's Pokemon Rumble logic for ya. Alright. Alright, Trico's the most powerful. Alright. And yes, we get 15 Poke Diamonds. Poke Diamonds are the game's currency. And, surprise, surprise, you can buy them with real money. But I do hear that there are ways to, get them in the game. So you don't have to deal with these shitty microtransactions. I hope. We're already 10 minutes in. Alright, get a hot air balloon at the shop. Alright. Yes, buying Poke Diamonds. Wait, free Poke Diamonds? You can get these via Street Pass. They give you weak ones, though. Alright, buying. No. Alright, so we get to choose. Grass type, water type, or fire type? Well, we have a grass type, so fire type is out. Do? Well, Trico's our most powerful, so water type it is. Alright. So we have to visit the balloon shop. Okay. Alright. Depart. The stage you select is determined at random. A star indicates a land where rare Pokemon can be found. It looks like Red Castle Farm entrance. Apparently, Flaffy's the boss. Alright. Alright, Torchic. Just totally killed that Mareep. Barrels give you money. Wonder how that works in real life. Kakuna. How do we get a Weedle? Alright, go into this hole. The hole of nothingness, that's what it is. Yeah, the autofocus is okay. Kaboom. Yes. Another Mareep. How do we get so much Mareep? Right? Another Mareep? I have three Mareep in a row. Yeah, three Mareep. This is like a hat trick. Wait. Oh, never mind. I thought they mistakenly classified Mareep as a normal type. Never mind. Another Weedle? Can we get better Pokemon here? I keep forgetting that you don't have to mash A. You can just simply auto-aim it. No boss yet, but still going in and killing a whole bunch of sheep. Hey, PETA, chew on this. Surprisingly, beating these things up feels kind of good. Ow! I'm poisoned! Time for a change of pace. Well, this game does have dual types. Again, unlike Shuffle, so at least they have better classification here. Wait, does it heal out when I switch? Yes, it does. Oh, wait. Yep. Heals when you switch out, so if you get poisoned, it's as easy as switching out. Another boss. This time, it's a Flaffy. Kill it with fire. Literally, kill it with fire. Alright, the boss is burned somehow. Uh-oh. I just killed one of your children, Flaffy. And that hurt, by the way. Ow, paralyzed. I guess this is what happens when you keep mashing A. Yeah, have some more variety next time. You've been doing this for, like, what, 4 installments now? Great, we beat it at least. So are Pokemon healed automatically, or do you have to pay $99 just to heal them? It's ridiculous. I don't think you have to do that, but hey. You gotta rank up. Hey, look. It's Soul Calibur. Character creation system. Alright. So you got 6 species of Pokemon. Alright, play data, blah, 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 blah. You want to activate Street Pass? Yeah, why not? I have to get jewels somehow. Or Pokediamonds, sorry. Alright, Spot Pass. Yeah. Alright, so you got extra data. Visitors. Meet characters who visited by communication sometimes give you Pokediamonds. You call someone online. Let's see what that does. Invite other players via the internet. Okay. Ah, shit. Misclicked. Why is it default to no? That's dumb. Alright. So we can call for players who somehow stumble upon this game. It's pretty great, I guess. We got Ryuna, Nobu, and Izanami. 3 Mii characters arrived. Alright, so what do they do? Whatever, let's just go back in the balloon stop. Some time must pass before it inflates again. So you gotta wait for 10 seconds? Fair enough, I can wait 10 seconds. Alright, we're ready. If you reach rank 5, they'll stop, which is sad. Alright, see what we get. Castle Moat entrance. Alright, a new stage. Here we go. Ooh, lots of fog. Yeah, I'm using the wrong type of Pokemon, I know. Gotta switch. Choose the Mareep. No, not the Treecko. Ugh. I got confused with the cursor. Oh, whatever. They're the same type anyway. They're the same effectiveness. Up there. I can't cross that. If I have a water Pokemon, can I cross it? Or do I have to know Surf? And my speed decreased. Gotta switch. I keep forgetting that Azurill's fairy type. Ooh, combo. Yeah. Gotta get Azurill. Izanami needs help. Yes. We got him. Arigato. I'll support you with X attacks. Alright. Giving us a boost. Attack up. Does it last even when I leave the room? It doesn't. Oh, he's giving me another one. How generous. Alright. Another Goldeen. Okay. This game's been alright so far. Oh, it's Nobu. Right, I think he went back home. Another boss. Frogadier. Alright. That's weird, because he's the same starter I picked for the Pokemon X. And look at that, I beat him instantly. Right. Alright, we got rank 3. We can now get a Sapphire Balloon, Ruby Balloon, and Pokemon House 1. Alright. And we got 25 more Poke Diamonds! Wow, this king is real generous with his Poke Diamonds, or his microtransactions. Alright, so let's go to the shop for a sec. I want to test this game's microtransactions out. Let's see how much Poke Diamonds cost. Alright, so the page is loaded. Let's see what we got. Okay. I'm kind of liking this. They give you 1,750 Poke Diamonds for only $16. And keep in mind, you can carry up to 3,000 Poke Diamonds. So for a microtransaction game, this is a pretty good deal. It's better than Pokemon Shuffle by a long shot, plus other mobile-based games. And they're even offering a discount on diamonds for a limited time. It's pretty cool. It's nice to know that their microtransactions are cheap. So what extras can we get? Alright, so we can get a higher capacity, and we need a higher rank to get all the rest, so hot air balloons. We can get and go to new destinations. A lot of these seem promising, and yes, they include all the Pokemon in this game. Not just a selection of Pokemon with the rest included in the game's data, like Shuffle. Little known fact, did you know that Shuffle has the rest of the Pokemon locked in the game's data? Thank you, Cutting Room Floor, for providing me with that information. And I'm not too sure where to go next, so I don't think I have a water. Yeah, I have a water Pokemon, so let's do another round. I'd say we should go to, Ember Balloon, since I have a water Pokemon. Sure. Alright, so roulette selection. Fireweed Field. This could get tricky. Right, so we're definitely going to need to switch for this. Goldeen, 82 power. Ow, that hurt, stupid fledgling. Oh no, it's Ryuna. Better help her from those Doduo. Alright. So she's giving us X speed. And we got a Poke Diamond. Nice. Bam. Kind of hard to control the attack, though. But I got a Fletchling. More enemy Pokemon in the way. Oh, I flinched. That's not fair. I didn't know there was a thing in this spinoff. Alright, so we got an X speed from Yuna. Fletchindler, the boss. Ah, watch out. We got another fledgling. We're killing its children. Doesn't matter, just beat it up. Oh no, watch out. And we beat it. Yeah. Doesn't matter if your Pokemon's HP is low. Just beat the shit out of that Fletchindler. Alright. So this will be my last stage for this recording. If you're ready, go to the castle. I'll leave that up to the other players. Alright, how do we save? Does it save automatically? Save and quit. Yes. Oh, it just leaves us with this bland screen. There's not even a title screen. That's weird. So, while this quiet selection plays here, my opinion on Pokemon Rumble World. It's actually a decent Pokemon game. I mean, sure, it's a monotonous beat-em-up and the graphics don't look their best, but hey, it's better than what Pokemon Shuffle could do. The microtransactions are cheap, the graphics actually have 3D turned on, and it includes all known Pokemon. So, I would say that Umbrella did a great job on making the free-to-play Pokemon formula right. I mean, it's a lot better than just matching 3 and not having time-traveling work. Oh, and I'm not really going to test out time-traveling because, like you saw in the video, the balloons regenerate within seconds, and there are multiple means of them. Overall, a pretty good game, better than what Shuffle can offer. So yes, this is G-Wizard signing off, subscribe for more, and good game.